Good evening and welcome to ATV News. My name is Shalima Lawson. On today's bulletin, a water project begins in Matabeleland. Seed fairs bring farmers together. Youths make money with comedy. And second-hand clothes become popular. Matabeleland Water Project is set for completion in the next 3 years and is expected to bring relief to communities in the drought-prone region. Crispin Tavura reports.
The Matabeleland Water Project that had been stalled for many years will finally commence next month after government secured $1.2 billion from China. Once completed, the project is expected to bring relief to the region that has been facing serious water problems. Speaking at the ceremony to unveil the project last week, Water Resources Minister Samuel Spepangomo said Chinese contractors would immediately commence the project.
There are a number of activities that are going to take place. This is a huge, huge project. And a number of subcontracting, a number of businesses in the corridor are going to be there.
The minister said construction of the water plant, which will be in three phases, will take 3 years to complete.
Our partners, China Dalian, are here. And we have been to their place. We have already signed a contract. And the contract stipulates that once they start, the contract takes 36 months. That's written 36 months.
A representative of business people in Bulawayo commended government for the project.
The city council has done a wonderful job in identifying those priorities. And you've seen the tremendous improvement in water and in sewerage, for example. And that couldn't have occurred without the assistance of partnerships with people who can provide resources.
Lower residents who have been experiencing water rationing for several years speak about the project.
Everything we have ngoba amanzi ama rates thina sibese amanzi every price yabe iphezulu kakhulu so kuza siyenza ukuthi price ibe phansi that's the nelisi uthola amanzi a clean.
A good project, but it has been on the shelf for quite a long time. We've been waiting that project for the people of Bulawayo to benefit, whether it will along the way it can perform some irrigation of some sort.
Once completed, the Zambezi Water Project will go a long way in alleviating water problems in the drought-prone Matabeleland region. Reporting for ATV, I'm Crispin Tavra in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe.
With high unemployment in Bulawayo, many youths in the city of Kings are performing comic acts in public to earn a living. Selum Hlanga gives us the story.
Abatsha ababili ko Bulawayo bathola imali yokuziphilisa ngokuhlekisa abantu. I-ATV ikhulume lalaba ababili baxoxa ngabakwenzayo okubatholisa inzuzo yokuphila.
Yeah, imali yakwazi ukuphila gakho. Yende parmina ngkhayena langa imali encane nale engireceiva.
Bathi umsebenzi wabo lo usiza abantu ukuthi bakhohlwe indubo zabo okwesikhatshana babobotheke.
Wena useke ukuthi hayi asiwabona ama-problems egesi asivalele. No, wasay let's laugh through them. As time kuyadlula.
Abantu abaningi bayawathakazelela amazwi abo ahlekisayo njalo sebelabalandeli abaningi.
Ngifeni kaNtando. I think Ntando is doing great things. He's a comedian.
Lapha eBulawayo lathi uyasibulala nge-speech singabangani yasizama ukumotivate lathi ukuthi ebe creative.
I want some things ama jokes are kekai and you wonder how ukuthi ubhala isikhathi bani, ucabanga isikhathi bani and everything. Yeah. I don't think it will go this far, but the only thing that I wish for him is the best.
Omunye wabahlekisi uchaza ngokumkhuthazayo ukuba ngumahlekisa lokumsiza ukucabanga amazwi awasebenzisayo kanye lamaphoqo.
izinto nje ezenziwa abantu, stupid things ezenziwa abantu, even nature, izinyamazana lana le TV, especially current affairs, people are always up to something, yabo.
Bathi abantu bayazemukela inhlelo zabo, kodwa bakhalaza ngabantu abakopa umsebenzi wabo kungela sivumelwano, okwehlisa inani labantu abathenga izidlalade ezilamaphoqo abo.
Eh, abantu bayamukela sibili like and staff said babuya bezobhena abanye bebuye lama flash bafake emafoni nabo.
Nginguselo Mhlanga, ngimele i-ATV kobulawayo
eZimbabwe. Seed fairs have become a regular event in Zimbabwe's agricultural calendar, with farmers in different parts of the country meeting regularly to share ideas and exchange seeds. Jeffrey Moyo attended one fair in Guruve.
Smallholder farmers held a seed fair at Chikokonya village in Guruve district last Friday to showcase crop diversity and strengthen local seed systems. Traditional varieties are being lost, and agricultural experts say seed fairs can at least help regenerate and conserve some indigenous varieties.
This will also allow the farmers to exchange, you know, the genetics material they have. As you can see, they are having a number of open pollinated varieties which have been preserved from older generations. And these are very important, especially when we are dealing with impacts of climate change.
Growing seeds suited to their soils can help improve crop yields for farmers.
Mbeu dza tiri kurima dziri kutibatsira kubvira muriwo nemapizi edu nemakabichi edu zvinotibatsira nokuti iko tinodya tichiguta ende ivhura charakawirirana nembeu nemushongo yacho yatinoisa.
Seed fairs also offer farmers a platform to exchange seed and share knowledge about farming techniques.
Zvipatanidzira kunyangwe nomuminda yatinenge tiri tinofanira kutedza izwi rinonzi invitation. Izwi rinonzi invitation rinobatsira kuti zvaunoita sezvamangwana zvine zvinobukira nokuti zvinenge zvichitedzana udzami hwasiyiwa nechimwe huchiwanikwa nechimwe chasiyiwa nechimwe chichiwaniwa nechimwe pachinhambo chokuti mbeu imwe neimwe irambe ichidya kudya ikoko.
The quality of seed on display was high, and farmers were upbeat about the crop yields they can get.
Inembeu dzedu dzatiri kuratidzira kuvarimi ndazvona zvakakosha chaizvo kuti mbeu idzodzo dzive dzinokurudzira utano hwedu muno munyika yedu yeZimbabwe nenherera dzedu varwere vedu tichivakurudzira vachidya mbeu idzodzo zvirimwa izvo zvatiri kurima mumagadheni.
Seed preservation is a big challenge for the farmers who said they need more support to enable them to secure their seed before the planting season.
Tiri vanhu vanenge vachiri pasi pasi pangwanirwe chemishonga yacho saka zvinenge riri dambudziko rokuti tinenge tichitsvaga vanenge vachitipa rubatsiro rwakafanana neveAfrica vatiri kubata navo mukati medunhu rineri. Vanhu vari kutibatsirawo nemishonga ingangoti neruzivo rwokuti tinofanira kuti tiite zvipi nezvipi.
The Guruve seed fair was punctuated by drama and song. Farmers also displayed a variety of traditional dishes and exchanged ideas on gardening and livestock rearing. Experts say more needs to be done to promote crop seed conservation to minimize the impact of climate change and other natural disasters on the livelihoods of smallholder farmers. Reporting for ATV, I'm Jeffrey Moyo in Guruve, Zimbabwe.
Buying second-hand clothes used to be considered a preserve of the poor, but flea markets in Bulawayo are attracting many visitors who say the used clothes are cheaper and stronger. Eunice Ferrazai reports.
As high unemployment takes its toll on Bulawayo residents, many people are now opting to buy cheap second-hand clothes commonly known as impahla zabokotamani. ATV visited some of the popular Kotamani Ben and Choose flea markets where buyers were seen jostling for clothes.
These days, imisebenzi yahlupha, so abantu abakwanisi ukuthenga izimpahla ezintsha ezodwa like kubo South Africa or emashopu lakhona Edgars. So indawo eziafodekayo ukuthenga impahla yiko Kotama, impahla ezamabheli.
Hayi, angiboni ukuthi Kotama uyaphambanisa amashopu anazilandani. Basically, I think abantu abafordayo they can go in my shops, abangafordayo they can go Kotama, and Kotama is selling some quality things kubantu abangatholiyo ngoba imali zethu ziyatshiyana singabantu siphila nje emhlabeni.
Vanhu vakuti amadola futuru nenyaya kuti vakuda kurarama kuti vabhadharawo marendi nokuda kuti basa makambani ringe riri kunetsa.
Mina dhala ngakuqinikapiya kukotama
But ngokuzwa kwami abantu bathi ukhothamo le best clothes, le best quality clothes.
Some shop owners quite fall over loss of business to the second hand clothes sellers.
Tinaba ma shops asisakwanisi ukuthi si thengisele wena abanye abantu ababe beswela. Ukuswela siyaswela sonke elizweni, but in terms of business thina sigcina sirana into seyinye mangalisayo.
Others urged for a free market, saying the competition that comes with it offers customers freedom of choice.
The issue about Kotamai and shops, it's fine, they are also in business at Kotamai there, but we have like regular customers who know the kind of stuff that they want, the classic unusual stuff that always come in here.
The closure of companies in Bulawayo in the last decade has put over 20,000 people on the streets. This has significantly reduced the disposable income of many households. Reporting for ATV in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe.
Thank you for joining us. Good night.